Right, so well, stop. This stream is going to require your download Tanami through Steam because the whole point is that it lets you synchronize he's watching videos on YouTube, Crunchyroll, all in Netflix. Use for an external program. Because it's being streamed, if you're watching it indirectly and not actually streaming the video or audio, you can just do everybody watching through Tanami will sync up and get to watch it through basically through the proper service so that nobody has to like litigate. There's no DMCA risk. So figured let's just try it and play this out. Let's just find something random on YouTube. Be able to watch for like an hour at most. Let's see. If I start doing this as like at least semi-regular thing, I might like add in some way to like display a browser window somewhere. Like maybe I could swap this out. We could swap out the screen display I've got not already. Since, as long as I'm not showing the video on the actual stream and instead just the stream for Tanami, it'll be fine. Because nobody's copyright is being infringed upon. Let's see. You just gotta find something good, maybe something that will last for like an hour. Think we've got to... All right, here we go. Here's something that I found after going through just sort of a bit of a rabbit hole. Well, yesterday. Okay, it looks like it's still fairly readable. Which means we're probably only gonna be watching this one video. So, I could probably just as easily put it in the description, and for YouTube. So yesterday I ended up just I found my way into a rabbit hole of just sort of foreign Sesame Street Muppets, like actually, instance, see if I spelled that correctly. No, I did not. Like, there's an entire category on the Muppet Wiki for just Muppets from non-American versions of Sesame Street. Like we've got Abelardo in parentheses reptile, because just I believe it's Mexico's previous equivalent to Big Bird. Like currently they have, from my understanding, they phased this guy out for a newer character called I don't want to drag a URL into OBS, I want to drag a picture. Copy the image and paste it in. Nope. Guess I've got to download the image and then drag it onto OBS. Like, for instance, this was apparently the original Big Bird from Mexico. Which honestly, I feel like in some ways, like if you're not gonna have Big Bird, you might as well have a dragon. It's just gonna remove that from the scene. So, well, I haven't looked into finding actual video of, like, say, Plaza Sesamo, which is a Mexican Sesame Street. I did find the original first episode of Sesame Street from 1969. And that's what we're going to be watching today. Video unavailable? Really? Well then, guess we aren't. Guess either it's been removed or I'm like not allowed to. Well, it's on YouTube. Guess it's just not. Oh, wait. Well, that kinda. Well, I just accidentally clicked on it. Sesame Street episode 16 and it worked. So I guess we're watching this now. Oh, they actually like showed what episode in the series it was. Which I'm pretty sure they've, you know, unless they've changed it since, and it's, you know, I was in the actual target demographic. It could, you know, back in like the mid-2000s at the absolute latest. Like actually like early 2000s, they've pretty much never changed the theme song in its entire run. Okay. Yeah, we have an ordinary banana. Or else I need. Guess I'll have to figure out where. I mean, you kind of ruined your trick. Are you sure, Ernie? I mean, it more makes a noise than makes music necessarily. I mean, if you. So that, I mean, well, somebody has already arrived. Like, you could literally see him in the corner. Well, that's so much for the trick. How do you just like misplay he's a violin? Like why would your violin then be in a drawer, dude? Good thing he got out of the way off screen. Yeah, that's an interesting specification to make. feel like they just straight up had these two people just walk around in an actual city making music, and they just zoomed in on random paths with bionic. They just sort of kept that ticker taken. Can I imagine when you're filming with children, then you kind of need. And yeah, you can only do so many takes in a day. Do we have any choice? No. What was the devious look? Just like getting real into it. Oh, good. We're starting with chapter one, which is good because kind of skipped over like 15 episodes. Well, a convenient coincidence. What a simple life it must be for, to have your entire existence be to just be like defined by jelly beans. Robin is having some kind of like what did you call the cow? Bossy? And when he hears the noise and puts magic glasses on, I guess the thing that makes the noise just manifests into existence. You mean the thing that made the noise exists somewhere? Otherwise it wouldn't be making a sound, but you could just sort of, like, the magic glasses just, like, make the thing visible. They don't, like, zoom in or anything. It just sort of appears. Ooh, we've got multiple layers now. This is some suspiciously detailed feet. Back to my favorite soap opera. Honestly, it's kind of interesting the way they use monster to mean something like frightening, but at the same time, like, monsters are also kind of people, basically. So, like, again, monsters like this one seem to be a bit more like feral and like borderline aggressive compared to, say, Cookie Monster. It's like, is there like a dynamic of like domesticated versus is. She's like, it's not my problem anymore. Like, I have to wonder if there's some kind of dynamic of like sort of domesticated monsters versus undomesticated ones. But then even this one's pretty like docile after he's had some jelly beans. What is this? That's I've just got Got this child conveniently here. He's very proud of his long neck. They could easily, you could easily make this entire conversation, an entire scene, like, very interesting by just swapping out two letters. Know, something that's even longer and larger than Big Bird's. You know, just swap out one word in all instances it appears in. It's another word that ends in the same two letters and is the same length. And also refers to an anatomical detail. Just kind of zooming in on this one particular graph. It sounded like a pipe. And this is like a legit book. Like you could probably, if you could identify the story, you could probably find the actual book. Oh, hold on. Did they really have a dog named Willie? Have it be a Dutch hound? You know, a wiener dog? Who's Burt Lancaster? Is he like somebody that was famous in the late 60s, or is he a character that they made up? I literally do not know. He's reading out the alphabet. When you don't want to, you clearly do not want to be involved in a conversation. Spontaneous. Just spontaneously doing like a bit now. Think they also like peak their microphone a little bit. They're honestly, you could probably make like this is the kind of thing that you probably see on YouTube, like burn Ernie in the glass of milk, in the cup of milk, but every time name Bert mentions a letter, an entire bit about, an entire like animated bit about but every time Bert mentions a number, remember, a whole animated bit play that's centered around that number or plays. And he just sort of was. Hold on. Well, today I learned that the audio at the beginning of a particular song by Panic at the Disco is sampled from a very old episode of Sesame Street. I mean, hey. could have just flipped it around.
I guess it just goes dark at that point.